First, we are going to make the back base. To begin, make a slip knot. And chain 56, it is equal 11 inches length. Next, we are going to make the bow crochet. To begin, skip 2 chains and make the bow crochet into the 3rd chain. To make the bow crochet, yarn over, insert the hook into the loop, yarn over, pull through the loop. So now you have 3 loops on your hook. Yarn over, pull through 2 loops, and yarn over, pull through 2 loops again. So this chain 2 also count as a stitch. Keep repeating this into every chain until you reach the end of the row, then I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, you must have 55 stitches include the chain 2 stitch. Next, we are going to make increase by make 6 double crochet into the same stitch. After you got 6 double crochet into the same stitch, next we are going to make double crochet into this stitch. Keep repeating this until you reach the end of the row, then I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, you must have 54 stitches because in this chain 2 stitch, we cannot make the bow crochet into it. So next, we are going to make increase again by make 6 double crochet into the same stitch. After you have made 6 double crochet, next we are going to make slip stitch to connect the row. Count 2 chain, then slip stitch into the 3rd chain. To make slip stitch, continue insert the hook into the loop, yarn over and pull through all the loops. So this is what the first row of the back base looks like. Next, for row 2, chain 2. Then make the double crochet into the stitch near chain 2. Don't forget to use stitch marker to mark where you had chain 2. Keep making the double crochet into every stitch around until you reach the chain 2 stitch or until you reach the stitch marker. Then I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, you must have 120 stitches in total. For the small loop near the chain 2, we are going to skip it, then slip stitch into the stitch where we mark. Next, for row 3, we are going to make the checkered or checkerboard pattern. To begin, chain 2, Remember, chain 2 also count as a stitch. Then make 4 double crochets. And we are going to change the color at the 6th stitch. Like I said, chain 2 also count as a stitch. After you got 5 double crochet include the chain 2, next we are going to make double crochet at the 6th stitch and switch the color. After you got 2 loops on your hook, then drop the pink yarn and grab the purple color. Yarn over and pull through 2 loops. So this is how you switch the color for the double crochet stitch. And for these 2 strands of yarn, we are going to bring it along with the row. Next, make 5 double crochet. Then we are going to switch the color at the 6th stitch again. Pull these 2 strands of yarn a little bit to give a nice entire stitch. After you got 5 stitches of double crochet, then make double crochet and switch the color. After you got 2 loops on your hook, then drop the purple color into the front of the stitch and grab the pink color into the back of the stitch. Yarn over and pull through 2 loops. Remember, for one color, you must have 6 stitches in total. Keep repeating this around until you reach the stitch marker, then I will meet you back again. Thank you. Like I said, for this small loop near the chain 2, we are going to skip it, then slip stitch into the stitch where we mark. Next, for row 4, we are going to repeat the same thing like row 3, then I will meet you back again at the row 5. After you reach the end of the row, next, for row 5, repeat the same thing like row 3, but at the end of the row or the last square, make 6 double crochet. We are not going to switch the color at the 6th stitch anymore. Thank you. So this is what the squares looks like. Remember, you must have 6 stitches and 3 rows of double crochet per square and 20 squares for around this back base. For the next row or the next square, we are going to repeat the same thing like the first square by repeat row 3, row 4 and row 5 until you have 29 rows in total or 9 rows of the squares. It is equal 12 inches length. Remember, the color of the square must be alternate with each other. After you got 9 rows of the square, next we are going to make the back strap. First, cut off the yarn that you don't need. For me, I cut off the purple yarn and I will use the pink yarn. Next, for rosette, continue from where your last stitch is, then chain 2 and make the bulk crochet around the back until you reach the chain 2 stitch, then slip stitch to connect the row. Next, count 3 squares or 18 stitches away from both sides and use stitch marker mark at the 18th stitch. You must have 23 stitches between both stitch marker. Then count the same number to the other side. Next, for row 31, chain 2 and make double crochet into each stitch until you reach the stitch marker. After you reach the stitch marker, then remove the stitch marker and make double crochet into the stitch where we mark. After you have made a double crochet, then continue make 105 chains. If you guys want the strap longer, please add more chains. After you got 105 chains, next we are going to make double crochet into the stitch where we mark. Make sure that the chain doesn't twist. Remove stitch marker. To make double crochet here, yarn over. Insert the hook into the loop. Yarn over, pull through the loop. So now you have 3 loops on your hook. Yarn over, pull through 2 loops. And yarn over, pull through 2 loops again. Next, continue make double crochet into every stitch until you reach the stitch marker and repeat the same thing like the first side. Keep making double crochet into every stitch until you reach chain 2 stitch, then make slip stitch to connect the row. After you have made slip stitch, next for row 32, chain 2 and make double crochet into every stitch and into every chain around the strap until you reach the chain 2 stitch, then make slip stitch to connect the row. Thank you. After you have made slip stitch, then chain 1. If you guys want the strap bigger, please add more rows by make double crochet into every stitch around the strap and slip stitch to connect the row. Next, cut off the yarn. For the remaining yarn, use darning needle to hide it. And if you guys want to know how to make these cherries, I will put the link in description below. And now your checker tote bag is done. If you like this tutorial, please don't forget to click like and leave a positive comment down below. Subscribe to my channel, turn on notification bell so you will notify when I post the video. Stay safe and stay healthy, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye bye.